No chalk. Rogue Fitness has been one of the largest innovators in the training equipment space. There's very few people who question that. Rogue Fitness knows what they're doing. They're trying to innovate. They're trying to create the best equipment. And in striving to be innovative, they've introduced the Rogue Cerakote bars. That said, the Cerakote bars from Rogue are not a Rogue innovation.
Hold up. Say what?
In fact, the innovator in this space, the first people to apply Cerakote to a barbell, at least as far as I'm concerned, was American Barbell. And I actually reviewed their bar in the past, the Mammoth Bar. It's one of the best power bars on the market, if not the best. That said, Rogue has some of the best general training bars at the best prices anywhere. Seriously, they have some of the best value barbells. And what they've done is taken their flagship general training barbell, the Rogue Ohio Bar, coated it in Cerakote, not just the shaft, also the sleeves, and then applied something I've never seen done before and applied a logo to the middle of the shaft. Now, most people, when they see a logo of a company on something like a barbell, they would not like it. And the reason is because people don't like a lot of branding. But Rogue has done so well in branding themselves that the Rogue label is seen as a status symbol. The steel that's used within the Rogue shaft is the traditional 190,000 tensile strength. They then throw on the sleeves, and traditionally these are coated in bright zinc, but they actually coated the sleeves in Cerakote, which this is the first time I've seen that done. Within the sleeve assembly is a bronze bushing on both sides, self-oiling bronze bushings. These are kind of the industry standard. Some people have gone to composite bushings. In reality, there isn't much of a difference between composite bushings and bronze bushings. Both are durable. Both are gonna be, you know, spin well. They're not gonna spin crazy good like a bearing bar, but they're gonna get the job done. So nothing about the Rogue Ohio Bar Cerakote bars is different. Okay, they just decided to coat it with Cerakote. Now, Cerakote is a coating that's traditionally used in firearms. At least a decade or so, they've been coating firearms in Cerakote. And Cerakote is considered to be about 70 times as strong as any coating that you could put on a barbell, okay? It's super corrosive resistant. It's very, you know, it doesn't crack, it doesn't, you know, fade. Basically, what you see on the barbell today is what you should see 10 years from now. One thing you notice about the Cerakote is it stays clean better than anything else. If you have a garage gym, if you have a home gym, and you don't like having rust spots on your bar, you don't like having, you know, the little corrosion that happens, the Cerakote bars are the best I've used, okay? I've used stainless steel bars. They can still develop some sort of, you know, rust on the top if you leave chalk and your sweat on there, but I have not noticed that with the Cerakote bars, okay? I've been using the American Barbell Mammoth Bar that's coated in Cerakote for 6 months or so, and it's about my daily driver for using a barbell, and it looks brand new, okay? I mean, it's an amazing coating, and to be honest, it's a lot better than I expected it to be, okay? I'd assume that when the coating was applied, it'd have to be applied very thin, because if you apply too thick of a coating, it's gonna ruin the knurl, okay? It's gonna make the knurl way more shallow, and then, you know, it's not really gonna be effective. That said, the coating is applied so thin that it doesn't really affect the knurl a whole lot compared to a zinc coated bar. Granted, it does against a raw steel bar. I've seen tons of companies come out with them, but in my opinion, the Ohio bar is one of the best general training bars for the money. Okay, I think the Rogue 2.0 in reality is the best value training bar, but the Rogue Ohio is pretty much the same. It's just at a little bit higher price point. One thing I'm curious to see is how the sleeves will be affected with plates sliding on and off. I have not seen any issues, and I've tried to slide the plates on and off quite a bit, dropped them, done all those different things to see how the sleeves will be affected, and they look way better at this point than, you know, bars that are coated in the traditional zinc coating. If you own a CrossFit affiliate or a gym and you want to provide, you know, a little bit higher level of class and, you know, just overall branding, having something like barbells that are the same color that match your, you know, logo is outstanding. Is it another way to separate yourself from the competition? If you have a home gym and you just like training equipment that's cool, this is awesome. If you want corrosion resistance, really, at least from what I've seen, this is the most corrosive resistant material that's been applied on a barbell, even better than stainless steel. But this has been Coop with GarageGymReviews.com. Let me know what you think of the new barbell, what you think of the new Cerakote being applied to barbells, and we'll see you next time.